In this lecture, I'm going to talk about the supremum and the infimum of a set. Here, A is the open interval minus infinity to 2. As you can see, 3 is an upper bound of this set because 3 is greater than or equal to any element of the set. 4 is also an upper bound of the set. In fact, any real number x that is greater than or equal to 2 is also an upper bound of this set. However, we are interested in the smallest upper bound of the set. And in this case, 2 is in fact the smallest upper bound of the set. So people call it the least upper bound of A or the supremum of A. So again, in this example, the supremum of A is 2. Now I'm going to give the formal definition of the least upper bound or the supremum of a set. Let A be a subset of the real line that is non-empty and bounded above. A real number alpha is called a least upper bound or supremum of A if the following conditions are satisfied. First of all, x is less than or equal to alpha for all x in A. That means alpha is an upper bound of A. The second condition says that alpha is smallest among all upper bounds of A. That means if M is an upper bound of A, then alpha is less than or equal to M. We can prove from the definition that if A has a least upper bound or supremum, then that least upper bound is unique. Therefore, we denote by sub A the least upper bound or the supremum of the set A. Now I'm going to give some examples of the supremum of a set. In the first example, A is the open interval minus infinity to 2. From the definition, we can see that 2 is the least upper bound or the supremum of the set A. In the second example, A is the closed interval minus infinity to 2. Note that here 2 is included, and we can show that the supremum of A is also 2. The difference between the first and the second example is that the supremum of A here doesn't belong to the set A. But here, the supremum of A belongs to the set A. And in the case where the supremum of the set belongs to that set, then the supremum of A is in fact the largest element of A. Now, in the third example, A is the set of all real numbers of the form x squared, where x is strictly greater than minus 2 and less than 1. We can easily see that A is in fact the interval 0, 4, where 4 is excluded. And from the definition, we can see that the supremum of A is 4. Now, there is a very natural question. That is, if A is a subset of the real line, under what conditions A has an upper bound? And the completeness axiom gives an answer for that question. In mathematics, an axiom is a statement that is largely accepted as true without proof. And the completeness axiom says that every non-empty subset A of the real line that is bounded above has a least upper bound. What does it mean? It means that if A is a subset of the real line and A is non-empty and bounded above, then the supremum of A exists as a real number. Now, in this example, A is the interval minus infinity to 2. Observe that A is non-empty and it is also bounded above. So by the completeness axiom, A has the least upper bound or the supremum. And in fact, the supremum of A in this example is 2. To continue, I'm going to give some conventions that give us a complete picture of the supremum of a set. Let A be a subset of the real line. First of all, if A is non-empty and bounded above by the completeness axiom, you know that the supremum of A exists as a real number. So now, what if A is non-empty and not bounded above? For example, if A is the set of all natural number, then it is not bounded above. So it doesn't have any upper bound. By convention, the least upper bound of A is infinity, or the supremum of A is infinity. Now, in the final case where A is the empty set, what happens? As you can see, any real number is an upper bound of the empty set. So you can pick, say, minus 100 is an upper bound of the empty set, minus 1000 is also an upper bound of the empty set. So what is the least upper bound of the empty set? By convention, it is minus infinity.